drift the most important things on the planes. We offer you guys 8 different badass super fast airplanes in this game with several unlockable skins to choose from. You're gonna unlock these planes by playing through the campaign. Only a few of those planes are unlocked with multiplayer game. We spent a whole lot of time to tweak these planes to have the final handing, to have the final balance between speed, maneuverability and stuff like that. The core of the gameplay comes from this. These planes are not real life plane models. You might see some part of them familiar, but these are whole new concept built and imagined and dreamed by our concept artists and tweaked in several steps to reach its final form. They are just like dragsters and race cars in the air. So it's not like military stuff. Even you can use power-ups to blow up your opponents. These are not military planes whatsoever. These are racing planes built for speed and for curves. If I have to compare Skydrift with regular track-based car racing games, you are on the ground, you are forced to stay on track and stuff like that. In contrast, in our game, you are not limited by the ground, you are not limited by gravity. You can fight against gravity and your opportunities are just 100 times more than in regular racing games. You have the whole world to play with. Of course, there are some restrictions where you cannot fly. We have a so-called racetrack, which is the part of the whole world, whole landscape, where you should go and you should find your way, your best spot and the ideal optimistic line. Simply, you are not limited by gravity and by boundaries. In Skydrift, every plane plays a bit different. It's really your call which one to pick for each event. There is no silver bullet thing for a track, like you pick this because if you're not, you're gonna fail. There's no such thing in our game. I'm not saying that there are no bad picks for a track. Not all the planes are good for a given event. But it really comes down to the player, to you, which one to prefer. Only slight difference in handling, in acceleration, speed, boost value, gives you a whole feeling about different play style according to a plane. So I know it's hard to believe, but we still can beat each other's lap record with different planes while knowing that they are totally different planes and they are still on par with each other. We really put so much testing and tweaking into these things, because if it's not good, the game won't last long, because the users will find out, pick this and you can face roll all the content. It's not the case in Skydrift. In multiplayer, you will see different kind of planes picked by the different users, and they will each compete for the first place. We have two guys in our team graduated as airplane technicians. But the rest of the team were not airplane fanboys, to say so, at the start of the project. We kind of like planes and its mechanical things and speed things, the usual stuff. Boys like planes at some degree. But as soon as we get involved in Skydrift and we dig deeper and deeper into airplanes, into flying, it became a really passionate connection between the designers, even the coders, between the individuals on the team and flying in planes. Kind of strong emotional connection started to show up according to airplanes and developers, and we always wanted to see this connection to show up on the guys who tested the game. If we put a new airplane model into the game and we gave it to some guys and test it and see if it's good or not, if it's good to play or not, and until they did not show emotions about that plane, even if it's hate or love, we knew it's not ready yet, because it's not just a metal case with wings which flies. It's a being. It's a thing which represents you in the game. It must be sexy, it must be strong, it must have emotional connection to you. And until it's not there, we are not right. And we tweaked again and adjusted even the colors, even the shape of the plane. Even changing the name could show some changes in the users. It was very interesting to see, and we really tried to make a strong bond towards these planes you can find in Skydrift.